Today, I'm going to discuss the design, manufacture, and basic testing of an open source and inexpensive 3D printed video laryngoscope with integrated phone mount. A number of open source video laryngoscopes for 3D printing have become available from a wide variety of inventors. With the proliferation of these devices, one design upgrade that I have yet to see as a standard option is adding a phone mount directly to the laryngoscope for ease of use. Within the resource-limited environments in which these 3D printed laryngoscopes are likely to be used, it seems logical that a single-handed device would be more efficient than an assistant holding the phone. Rather than making a new 3D model from scratch, to expedite this project, I remixed a couple existing open source projects. I used a laryngoscope from Projecto ALBA, which was designed by a group of engineers in Mexico during the early portion of the COVID-19 pandemic in 2020, along with the second project, a universal phone tripod mount. Links to both projects and their creators are in the video description below. I modified the models in CAD so that they would easily mount together. I prepared the model for printing with Prusa Slicer. I printed the project on a Prusa i3 MK3 at 0.3mm layer height with 20% infill with Hatchbox brand PLA. The print used 90 grams of filament, costing approximately $1.75. The 3D printed parts assemble easily. The tabs for the phone mount fit snugly into the laryngoscope, but I added a few dabs of glue around the perimeter to hold them together permanently. The phone slides into the mount and tightens in with the screw on top. An inexpensive 7mm USB endoscope slips into the handle and out the bottom. It plugs into the phone's USB-C port. The endoscope camera slides into the end component and locks in place. In the first revision of the project, I used the endoscope as is and had to wrap the extra wire around the scope multiple times, making it awkward and cumbersome. I was able to easily improve the usability of this device by cutting out the excess wire and splicing the ends together, as well as adding shrink tubing for a finished look. These inexpensive endoscopes don't have any markings as to orientation, so one needs to be mindful to rotate the camera to the correct upright orientation before locking it into place. Unlike a regular video laryngoscope, the camera depth on this 3D printed device is not fixed, so it can be changed to suit the operator's preference. If we compare the images of a GlideScope and a McGrath Mac, we see that the different manufacturers may choose to fix the camera more distally or proximally on the device. With a 3D printed laryngoscope, the camera depth can be easily changed and locked back into place at any time. Another unique advantage is the ability to quickly change the camera brightness, a feature not available on any popular commercially produced laryngoscope. Exploring further the unique features of this setup, the device allows you to record intubation pictures and video directly to your phone. Although many commercial video laryngoscopes offer video recording, they lack the convenient internet connectivity that comes standard on one's phone. This introduces a unique ability to share important medical interventions easily and in real time. Imagine being able to immediately share a difficult airway case via your phone versus spending an hour figuring out each manufacturer's proprietary software and hardware. Now that we've discussed the 3D printed laryngoscope in depth, let's test it out against a commercial device. We'll compare the 3D printed device with a GlideScope, a very popular video laryngoscope used in many hospitals in the US. The GlideScope inserts easily into this model and produces a clear grade 2A view, allowing for a straightforward intubation. Comparatively, the 3D printed laryngoscope also produces a clear grade 2A view, allowing for a straightforward intubation. Comparing the two views side by side, we see that the $7 3D printed device provides a non-inferior intubation view to a $3,000 commercial device. 3D printing is an intrinsically sterile process, and if the part is handled in a clean manner after printing, it can be safely used without additional cleaning. One would likely want to reuse the endoscope component, which would require it to be cleaned between uses. Although cleaning it with a harsh disinfectant would probably be adequate, it would likely be cleaner and more efficient to find some sort of inexpensive, disposable cover for this portion of the endoscope. I haven't found a product just yet to fit this application. Something like a thermometer cover is too small, and ultrasound probe cover too large. Let me know in the comments below if you know of a product that might fit this application. And finally, a brief cost analysis of the project. The cost of the PLA filament used was $1.78. I purchased the USB endoscope from Aliexpress for $4.25. I needed an adapter to connect the endoscope to my phone, which I got off eBay for 89 cents, and I used a few pieces of shrink tubing from a large previously purchased package, which I estimate the cost to be about 10 cents. The grand total, only $7. Given the extremely low cost and obvious non-inferiority to commercial devices, one can see why 3D printing is becoming a vital tool for medical providers around the world. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching.